Hi, welcome to the Online Jewelry Academy. I'm Professor John Ahr, and I'm your instructor. Now, I've gotten a ton of emails from you guys asking me to finish the earring project video. Guess what? I'm gonna do that right now. And for those of you who didn't even see that first one, that's okay. This is a great video too, because it's gonna focus on making ear wires. And what good are earrings without ear wires, right? Nobody can wear them. So in the previous video, I made the bottom part of this earring right here. And today we're gonna focus on making that very top finding, that ear wire finding. If you look on the velvet over here, I've got some ear wires or ear findings that you can buy at a commercial bead store. These are leverbacks, and this is a French ear wire. We're going to make one like this to put on this earring. Over here, I've got the tools that you're going to need. You're going to need just a standard set of jewelry pliers. They have no serrations on the jaws, and they include a diagonal cutter. Now mine are a little bit special because I took my rosary pliers and I dressed them up with stripes, and oh boy do they smell good. They have children's nail polish on them. It's just like sniffing markers. Anyway, not really. Anyway, these are great because if you check out the video in the bench tips and tricks on the website, you'll see that there's a video on wire loop consistency, and the secret is these stripes that I've painted onto the pliers. I also have over here an emery board. It's not just because I'm bored and want to do my nails, it's because why buy a file or why bother making a sanding stick if you can just use an emery board? For this project, it'll work just fine. But if you do want to make sanding sticks, the OJA has another video that's just on how to make a sanding stick. I've also got two types of wire on the table. I've got 20 gauge round copper wire and 20 gauge round sterling silver wire. The copper wire is here just because I want to remind you guys, you need to practice. Practice, practice, practice. Get your craft down so that things are perfect, because you wouldn't want to sell schlocky stuff to your friends and colleagues or strangers. You want to sell beautiful jewelry that really represents who you are as an artist. And the sterling silver is great too, because unlike the copper, it's not going to give you a nasty ear infection if you put it through your ear. And the precious metal adds to the value of your project, making it a little more valuable, something people will want to hang on to and treasure. I also have up here a cross peen hammer. Now the shape of the hammer isn't really important. What's important is that it has this really shiny surface right here. It's so shiny that you could like check your lipstick in it. This combined with a shiny striking surface, this is a bench block. If I go like that with a piece of metal in between, both sides of that piece of metal are going to receive a shiny impression. I don't have to polish. Cuts down on the work. And who doesn't want to cut down on the work? All right, let me get ready and we're going to start the project. Now, somebody told me that I always had to be camera ready, so this is my look. It's an apron. You want to protect your clothing when you work with jewelry projects, and you may want to protect your skin too. So having an apron is a great idea. Because we're working with wire, I suggest you put on a pair of eye protection. You only got two eyes, protect them. All right, step number one, cut a length of wire that's about 2.5 inches long from your 20 gauge round sterling silver wire. Then pick up your round nose or rosary pliers, and you're going to insert the wire about 3/4 of an inch from the end into the jaws of the plier. And be consistent. Last time I used the area where the blue stripe is painted, so I'm going to be consistent and use that same spot for this video. All right, tug on the end of the wire. Good things happen with a little tug. And you're going to turn a loop. Now, I can't go any further, so I'm going to lighten up my grip, go back, and continue turning until I end up with a little loop under my wire. If you did it backwards, you might have ended up with a loop on the top, but you just want a loop on your wire. Okay, if you're there, good. Let me stop you right here. You may want to write this down and take notes, because I have been teaching this to students for years, and students will come back to me years later and say, Can you demonstrate the ear wire again? Now you have the advantage of watching this video again, so add this video to your like video so you can find it again, but take some notes too because it'll help. Okay, I've got the loop. Now where that naughty wire is touching itself, I'm gonna go, shame on you, and pinch it with the tip of the pliers. So I'm going right to the very end of the jaws of the plier, and I'm gonna take the long end of the wire and pull it straight up. So right now I've got a capital letter L riding a unicycle. If you've produced any other shape, you did it wrong. It has to be this shape, okay? All right, we're gonna go to the next step now. You're gonna use the same pliers and you're going to pinch across the loop, just like that. When you pinch across, hold it tight, and you're gonna take the shorter end and you're gonna pull it and begin to wrap it around the longer length of wire. Now, you better be paying attention to what you're doing at this point because you need to be consistent as a designer. For me personally, I like to make it with three loops around the longer wire. So right now I've got like one, two, and the third one starting, and I can't do it anymore. So I picked up a different pair of pliers, and I'm gonna use these strong little baby fingers and push it all the way around. Okay, and I'm gonna squish and manipulate this so that I have it perfectly where I have a little noose. You can see that little noose at the end of my wire with three wraps around. Now if you're consistent, let's pretend you made a pair of earrings for a client somewhere and she loses one and you gotta remake another one for her. Well, if you consistently put three loops on your ear wire, you don't have to ask to see the other earring so that you can match it perfectly. And if you always work in the same spot on your pliers, it'll hang to the exact same length as the other one because you're consistent. You're a master of earrings. Okay, I'm gonna dress this up a little more by getting rid of the little teeny piece of wire that's sticking out on here. And I'm just gonna take my diagonal cutters, or my dykes, not that kind of dyke, and put my finger over it and go snip, snip, there it is. Save your scraps. Little things like that add up and you can use them in casting projects. All right, once you snip that little bit off, take the pliers again and I'm just gonna squish and pinch and I'm gonna make sure that that little teeny end of the wire is tucked away so that it doesn't poke somebody and hurt them. Then I'm going to pick up the emery board and I'm just going to go like that, just until that's nice and smooth. And you can see it really didn't scuff anything up too badly. All right, now what I can do is I can pick up the pliers again, these same stripy pliers, and I'm going to go back to the very tip. And what I want to do is I'm going to push the wire forward. Actually, I'm going to push it all the way down. Look at that. I'll lay it down so you can see. So I made that noose and then I went all the way down. Now what I want to do is I want to use the same tip of the pliers, but I'm going to reposition. This time I'm going to be in more of a vertical position. And what I want to do is I want to push that wire up and slowly over and around and down to make that shape. Now it's a little cattywampus, but with a little bit of tweaking, I can come back in with my pliers. And if you know how to use your pliers really, really well, guess what? You can turn it into a very beautiful French ear wire with little effort. But we're not done yet. I got to get rid of that sharp spot on the end of the wire. So I'm just going to use my emery board to sand the end of that wire, and you can use your own ear. Make sure it's not pokey. Remember, don't want to hear the word ouch in jewelry or lovemaking. Okay, so that's pretty darn good. And you can finesse it and make it really curvaceous and beautiful. The last part is connecting the bottom of your earring to your ear wire. And I'm going to pick up a pair of chain nose pliers, and I'm going to open up the connecting loop that's at the top of this bead. And when you open up a connecting loop, they're rounded. So you want to open them like a ballerina, you know? You don't want to go like this, like you're giving a hug, because you'll never get it back to being round. So you're going to open it up and just slide the ear wire in and then shut it right back down. And it's nice and dangly, and girls like things that dangle near their head, so it's perfect. Let me show you a couple more things that'll make this even better. Take your hammer, lay the ear wire, just the curve of the French ear wire on the edge of the bench block, and give it a couple of little light raps. Okay, and what you've done is you have forged the top part of this earring so that if a client opens this up, puts it through her ear hole, and then closes it back down, it goes back to being perfect again. I hope you like this video. If you like it, give us a thumbs up on YouTube and share this video with your friends who might want to make some ear wires. And feel free to post images of your projects to our Facebook page. We'd love to see what you're doing. Check out our other videos and products on the onlinejewelryacademy.com. Thanks for watching.